"This time, Ozma, it isn't I," she replied. "But it's worse, I guess, for Uncle Henry and Aunt Em are in a heap of trouble, and there seems no way to get them out of it, anyhow, not while they live in Kansas." "Tell me about it, Dorothy," said Ozma, with ready sympathy. "Well, you see, Uncle Henry is poor, for the farm in Kansas doesn't amount to much as farms go. So one day Uncle Henry borrowed some money and wrote a letter saying that if he didn't pay the money back, they could take his farm for pay. Course, he expected to pay by making money from the farm, but he just couldn't. And so they're going to take the farm, and Uncle Henry and Aunt Em won't have any place to live. They're pretty old to do much hard work, Ozma, so I'll have to work for them, unless..." Ozma had been thoughtful during the story, but now she smiled and pressed her little friend's hand. "Unless what, dear?" she asked. Dorothy hesitated, because her request meant so much to them all. "Well," said she, "I'd like to live here in the Land of Oz, where you've often invited me to live, but I can't, you know, unless Uncle Henry and Aunt Em could live here, too." "Of course not," exclaimed the ruler of Oz, laughing gaily. "So in order to get you, little friend, we must invite your uncle and aunt to live in Oz also." "Oh, will you, Ozma?" cried Dorothy, clasping her chubby little hands eagerly. "Will you bring them here with the magic belt, and give them a nice little farm in the Munchkin Country, or the Winkie Country, or some other place?" "To be sure," answered Ozma, full of joy at the chance to please her little friend. "I have long been thinking of this very thing, Dorothy dear, and often I have had it in my mind to propose it to you. I am sure your uncle and aunt must be good and worthy people, or you would not love them so much. And for your friends, Princess, there is always room in the Land of Oz." Dorothy was delighted, yet not altogether surprised, for she had clung to the hope that Ozma would be kind enough to grant her request. When, indeed, had her powerful and faithful friend refused her anything?